The race for new COVID treatments.
Medical reporter Dina Baer has the latest on that, and we have to warn you, some of the video in this story may be too graphic for some viewers.
First, it was the quest for COVID tests. Then scientists scrambled to develop vaccines. Now millions are protected, but some are reluctant to get the inoculation, and that means new variants can threaten health. So brilliant minds are once again back in the lab, this time rushing to find a treatment so anyone diagnosed with COVID-19 will not succumb to the disease. Pfizer was the first to launch human trials for its pill. IIT has an inhaled drug in the works, and now University of Chicago is applying cancer research to COVID. They're cancer researchers at University of Chicago's Pritzker School of Molecular Engineering. Before the pandemic, they were working on a way to use the tiniest particles, known as nanoparticles, to kill tumor cells. But their concept was moving slowly until COVID hit.
We started to think how we can actually do anything can help, you know, prevent pandemic.
It was Min Chen's idea to apply their cancer treatment platform called a Nanotrap to COVID-19, the infection caused by SARS-CoV-2.
Nanotrap is kind of very small particle. The size is just 1% of your hair thickness, and it can catch and destroy as a coronavirus.
Unlike a typical human cell, the team's nanotraps are loaded with ACE2 receptors, the same receptor the SARS-CoV-2 spike proteins bind to in the human body.
The ACE2 that we have on the nanotrap surface is much more than a typical lung cell would have. So the virus immediately sees the nanotrap and binds to it instead of your cells.
Once the nanotraps gobble up the virus,
it signals to the body's own immune system to grab it, degrade it, and kill it. And so both the nanotrap and the virus are going to be degraded by your own immune system.
The researchers had an opportunity to test the treatment in human lungs.
So this is a set of human lungs that were not viable for transplant.
In the lab, the donor lungs were hooked up to a ventilator, given a blood source, and injected with the virus. Then the nanotraps were sent in. After several hours, the team tested the tissue.
We found that the nanotraps completely eradicated the infection. When we got the data the next day that it worked, it was really exciting because we don't get these lungs very often, and it worked on the first try, which is very incredible. This is a tube of the nanotraps themselves.
They're stored in liquid that can be applied to the virus's earliest points of entry.
This is what could be formulated into a nasal spray or an eye drops, an IV injection. It's very flexible.
Other experiments, including one using the live virus at Argonne National Labs, showed the nanotraps inhibited the virus 10 times better than antibodies, typically triggered by COVID infection. And the team believes the nanotraps will yield power over variants as well.
Then we know this great potential, how this nanomedicine can really help to, you know, prevent the disease.
Might the nanotraps change the trajectory of their cancer research?
I believe so. I think it represents the future to me.
Dr. Wang and his colleagues now hope to hand off their platform to a pharmaceutical company that can help take the technology to the next level and ultimately drugstore shelves. Back to you.